Hello everybody, this is Mr. Fae, and here we have one more Single Mastery build. This time we play with Single Mastery Rogue build, which of course uses the Rogue Mastery. Now, what is this idea behind this build? The idea was of course once again to get, if possible, all of my primary resistances up to 80%. And as we can see here, with this specific build, we have everything at 80% except for Vitality Resistance, which is 71% only. Well, actually not only, because 71% is very close to perfection. 80% is perfect because it is the maximum cap. We have a very nice setup which allows us to have these very nice numbers here. And we also have a very nice combined armor, as we can see the numbers here. And on top of that, we have physical resistance. So, not only do we have great resistances, primary resistances, but we also have a very nice physical resistance because the combined armor, the armor, mitigates incoming physical damage, and of course this physical resistance does the same thing. In this series of single mastery builds, we do not try to get this specific resistance at 80%. This resistance does not work the same as these ones. For example, these resistances, these 7 resistances, they get a penalty, difficulty penalty. So you start in normal difficulty, you have 0% of all of these resistances. You go to epic difficulty instantly, all of these 7 resistances lose 40%. Because this is how the difficulty level works. So, if for example in normal difficulty you have 0% lightning resistance, when you start epic, it goes down automatically at -40%. And in legendary, you lose 60% more, which means that it goes down to -100%. And this is the natural cap you can have. 80% the positive natural cap of resistances, at -100% the natural cap, the bottom low of course, cap, the negative cap of resistances. This one doesn't get any penalty because it is a different resistance, but we can see it here. It was a very nice decision of the developers actually to put this resistance here, because you can see the combined armor and also this resistance. They work not together, but this one works in addition to this one, and it shows you how, if you have more physical damage mitigation with this one here. This is the goal, to have 80% all of these ones. Everything is 80% except for Vitality, which is 71%, which again is very very good. In Legendary, 71%, it is awesome. And we also have 4000 health points. The way I decided to go and spend my points here attributes is to spend points of Strength and on Dexterity. As we can see, only Strength and only Dexterity. And I have these numbers here of Strength and Dexterity. I want you to do that because this is a Rogue Mastery build. Single Mastery Rogue. And I wanted to use to spend my attribute points here because this would allow me to equip some very nice items that help very much with melee combat builds, strength based builds, and things like that. But before we talk about the items of the setup, let's check out the Rogue Mastery. Of course, we don't have a second mastery selected. There is no reason to do that, to select one, because we don't play with two masteries. We play only with Rogue. I have maxed out all of the skills, as we can see, that I'm using currently. I'm using the Calculated Strike. It is down here. It is my main skill, of course. I always hit with this one. By the way, the best way to benefit from skills that have procs or they have charged levels is to attack as fast as possible with those skills. So, this one has 3 charged levels. It means that you hit once, you hit twice, you hit a third time your enemy, and the next attack, the fourth attack, will release this one effect here, which is this big amount of flat piercing damage and also this super good amount of physical damage. This will be released in the fourth attack. And to be able to use this attack, this skill here, more frequently, you need to have fastest attacking speed. Because the faster you attack, the more frequently you release this skill here and you deal more damage in less period of time. Of course, we have this one as well, which is super awesome. We use these ones here. We have this one, Blade Honing, of course. It increases our damage because we play with a sword, which is a bladed weapon. And this one works with bladed weapons only. It doesn't work with staffs, for example, or with hammers, or with bows, but it works with swords, with axes, and things like that. Open wood. We have the anatomy. We have the throwing knives. This build uses throwing knives as well. We have the flurry of knives. We have the disarm traps, of course. We have lay trap, rapid construction. All of the skills are maxed out at on +3, as we can see. I have +3 because I'm using some items that provide +3. Okay, this is not maxed out. This is not maxed out because I didn't have so many points to spend on all of my skills. Later, I will be, you know, leveling up with this character. Later, when I level up, I will put points here. Points here, I will max out the skills, and then I will also start using this one. I don't know exactly when, before I max out this one probably, but because it is very good, it helps us, it helps with survivability. But anyway, you get my point. The point is that I have almost everything maxed out. It is only this skill that I haven't activated yet. This one I haven't activated yet, and this one are not maxed out. But I guess that after I finish Legendary Difficulty, if I reach level 75, maybe I will be able to max out all of these skills. This skill is very powerful, by the way, but I decided to go with throwing knives this time, not with this one, and later I will activate this one as well. We can see all of the skills down here. Lay traps and whatnot. A venom weapon, which is something like an aura, which gives you, it is not really an aura, but let's call it an aura because you activate it once and it remains active until you get killed or until you get it deactivated somehow. This is Blade Honing, and here we have on the left mouse button the calculated strike, which we use all the time. So the calculated strike, oops, is this one. Chaka, 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 chaka. We have a fast attacking speed, as you can see, because we have attack speed 204%. With a shielded one-handed weapon, this can go up to 222%, which is the maximum attacking speed you can have. You know, just remember that with different setups of weapons and different types of weapons, you have different maximum, different caps of attacking speed. So with dual wielding, for example, thrown weapons, the attack speed I think is 144%, if I remember correctly, the cap of attacking speed with dual wielding thrown weapons. Dual wielding melee weapons, such as swords for example, or hammers, the attacking speed cap is 200%, if I remember correctly. So yeah. Anyway, the idea is to have the fastest attacking speed possible, because as I said before, we want this one effect to trigger as frequently as possible. And as you can see, we have a very nice attacking speed. So this build has become, I could say, a quite powerful melee combat build. But it is not that we use this build as a melee build. We use it also as a trap build, because we use all the time this skill. As we can see, the cooldown of the skill is 0.8 seconds, not even 1 second. And we can have many of these, up to 3 on the floor. At the same time, we use this one, we use this one, we use the throwing knives all the time. Of course, it costs lots of energy using throwing knives all the time, which we don't want to use, of course, all the time, like this, I mean. And I'm not using it like this, I'm using this one mostly, sometimes this one, sometimes this one, and I hit with my melee weapon, and of course I use this super duper powerful attack, which is the lethal strike. This attack is super duper powerful. So, when it comes to damage numbers, Because some people pay too much attention to these numbers. Sometimes it is the right thing to do, but other times it is not, because you will see many builds that rely heavily on spells and skills to kill enemies, and the damage of spells and skills is not calculated here. So these damage numbers, sometimes for some builds, they are a bit irrelevant to the performance of the build. But anyway, these are the numbers without having activated my Envenom weapon and the Blade Honic. You can see 13, 40, 27, 29. Let's activate Envenom weapon. It goes up to 22, 34, 45, 50. And by activating the Blade Honic, it goes up to 24, 71, 50, 33. So, by having these two skills active, we deal much more damage now. And the build is awesome. So, when it comes to items, well, let's start with the artifact. It is the Star of Istar. A very good. This is one of the greatest artifacts in the game, I would say, legendary artifacts at least, because it gives some very nice stats. I mean, the physical resistance and elemental resistance are always useful for each type, all kinds of builds. And also the dexterity and strength buffs percentages are again useful for many, many builds. Dexterity is useful for every single build of the game, but the strength, okay, if you play with a mage build, you don't need the strength, but maybe you play with a hybrid build, which is something like a battle mage, which needs both strength and intelligence. So this item works very, very nicely. And the completion bonus was energy, which is very helpful in this case, because as we can see, we don't have lots of energy. I have only 510, and I get 210 energy from this one. I mean, imagine. And we need energy, not so much, because if you use this one, for example, you lose some. If you use this one, you lose very little energy. It is throwing knives that cost most of the energy, especially if you start using it all the time. This would be a problem. But this is not how I play this build. So, after all, I don't need to play this build with throwing knives alone, because I deal good damage also with my main attack. Very good damage. At least in the first half of legendary difficulty of the whole campaign. Later I will be using more of these throwing knives maybe, but everything will be fine. This artifact is a great one. Here we have the Babizi G. I don't know how they pronounce this thing. But this thing is a perfect item. I think this is one of the best legendary items in the game for Rogue Mastery. Even better than most of the items of Ragnarok and of course Atlantis for Rogue Mastery. It is an old item. This item belongs, I think, to Immortal Throne or even to the classic base Titan Quest game. I don't remember if it came with Immortal Throne, but it is an older item than Anniversary Edition. I found this item, this specific copy that you see here. I found it with an old character of mine back in the days of the Immortal Throne version, when there was no Anniversary Edition yet, and I brought it with that old character in my Anniversary Edition, and this is how I have it. I haven't found it yet in Anniversary Edition as a drop. I think I haven't found it. I don't remember having found this as a drop. But it is very powerful as an item, because it provides so many resistances, also pierce damage buff and total speed, which we got for this build, and Rogue Mastery skills. Here we have the Tirfing. This item is coming with Ragnarok, of course. It is a very powerful sword. I use it because of the attack speed and of course the elemental resistance. Remember, with this series of single mastery builds, my main concern, my main goal, my primary goal is to get all of my resistances up to 80% if possible. So, when I look at items in general, I look at items, the first thing I look in my items is to see if they provide resistances and what kind of resistances, and if I can use them in combination with the rest of my setup when it comes to resistances. So, this is the best item I had in my collection currently, with this elemental resistances, attack speed, splash onto the skills, and recharge reduction. This item is super duper awesome. Very, very. I think this item is perfect for this specific build. and for Rogue Mastery overall. Here we have the Star of Elysium, one more item which is super duper perfect for Rogue Mastery. Because of the buffs to Bleeding, Poison, Pierce, Physical Damages, the Resistances and of course the Health and Health Regen and Strength. This health number is very important because we have only 4200 health. If we take this one off, we lose a health, but we lose access also to some other items, as we can see. Oh, now I cannot use this one. Why? Oh man, I totally forgot it. I totally forgot it. So, as we can see, without having this one here, we lose Pierce Resistance and Bleeding. So, yeah, anyway, it doesn't really matter right now. We can see how important this item is. Here we have this one, the Anaplectic Skullcap. This is a Mastery Frequent item. It is an awesome item, actually, because this specific version, I think I got this one from a trading giveaway. You know, every Saturday this community we play multiplayer Titan Quest and we give away items for free and we trade items, but not cheat items, legit items only. And if I remember correctly, one of the players of this community gave this item to me to give it to somebody else. Nobody asked for this item and I kept it for myself. And it was a very good decision because it helps greatly with this build. As we can see, it provides many very nice resistances that help very nicely with the build. Elemental, Lightning, Skill Disruption Protection, 80% of physical resistance. And I have decided to go with the Vinic Growth, which provides health regen and more vitality damage resistance. We have 71% with this one here. So this item is perfect for this build. Here we have the Resistance Kickers of the Tinkerer. This is an Atlantis item. By the way, this is not an Atlantis item. This is an Immortal Throne item, as far as I remember. Yeah, this one, I use this one for the resistances, of course, and also the health points. As we can see, I tried to stack some health with this one here, because at the 700 health from this one, because as I said before, we don't have so much health. This is a very nice item here. It helps very much with survivability, resistances. Here we have the Seed of Skald, again resistances, total speed which is super important, and Mystic Circle activated upon taking great damage skill. Which helps, it has only 3 seconds cooldown, which is awesome, I mean the skill, the Mystic Circle skill, which is awesome, and it helps very much of course with everything, both survivability, when it comes to resistances mostly, not blocking chances, damage output. Here we have the Jormungand Guards. These items, by the way, are Ragnarok items, these two. This one is a Ragnarok item. It is a very nice item for this class and this build. It is a perfect item because of all of the things that it provides. I mean, plus poison damage with improved duration. We apply poison damage all the time because we play with Venom weapon. Improved duration and 22 attack speed, casting speed, recharge reduction, rogue mastery skills, and also activated upon taking melee damage flame surge skill. Everything is awesome about this item for this specific build. Here we have the Essence of Styx. I'm using this one for the health, defensive ability, armor protection, super important, plus 31%. And of course, the resistance, elemental, poison, energy, leech, resistance. All of these things are super duper important. And this one now, which I cannot re-equip. To equip this one again, I have to go back to my stats, get another item that can give me some more strength points to equip it here again, and then take re-equip the rest of my setup. I will do it later. Now there is no point to do that. But as you can see, this item is super duper awesome. It is a Ragnarok item. It comes with a super high base armor, 760. It comes with very nice resistances. Pierced Bleeding, as you can see, Pierced Bleeding. Take it off. Pierced Bleeding. This is what I get when it comes to resistances from this one. I cannot equip it now. And it also provides this percentage of strength. Actually, this percentage of strength allows me to have this one equipped here. If I equip maybe an Alki here or here to get some more strength to be able to equip this one and then unequip the Alki, Then this will remain here equipped because it provides 17% strength. In combination of course with this one which provides 32 strength. This is why I would have to equip Alki here, because this one provides no strength buffs. And here we get also health and movement speed and less damage from Beastmen. So, this is guys the setup. Yeah, forget about this one, I cannot equip it right now again, but it doesn't really matter, because I'm not going to play right now. This build is very very good, the survivability rate is super very good. Defensive ability of the build is 618, this one doesn't provide any defensive ability, so you can see now the final number of defensive ability, and offensive ability is 552. When you play with melee attacks in legendary difficulty, to be sure that you will never miss attacks, you need around 800 offensive ability. If you have around 600 offensive ability, again, you can hit most of the enemies of the game in legendary difficulty. I mean, 90%, 95% of the enemies, you will not miss with your attacks, these enemies. With 600. With 800 you start dealing more critical hits as well, so yeah, this is why 800 is the ideal number. Ideal balancing number, to have a balance between hitting enemies and dealing some critical damage. But this one is not the best number, but this is not really a problem for this build though, because you know, we use many times these skills, and these skills throw knives also. These skills do not rely on offensive ability. Offensive ability is totally useless for these skills. This one though, it is the lethal strike, uses your weapon, the sword, to attack enemies. So, for example, if you have a very low offensive ability, hypothetically, you have 300 offensive ability in legendary, which is super low, and you use lethal strike, there is a chance that your lethal strike will not hit the enemy. It will miss the enemy because your offensive ability is very low. Why is this happening? Because lethal strike utilizes your weapon. It uses your weapon to attack with. It is not for example, if you don't have a weapon, the right type of weapon, you cannot use shield strike. Lethal strike. So, you need to have the right type of weapon to be able to use lethal strike, because this one requires the right type of weapon. And this is why you should remember this detail. This also happens with other types of skills and weapons. For example, the shield charge of Defense Master works similarly. If your offensive ability is super low, you will be able to use the skill shield charge on enemies. You will see the animation happening, the animation of the shield attack will happen, you will attack your enemies, you will hear the sound effect of the attack, but your attack will not hit the enemy, not really, you will miss. You will see this attack animation, but you will miss the target. But yeah, we have these three skills. These three skills are AoE skills. They deal lots of damage. So there is no problem actually here. No problem at all. And this build currently is very powerful for the beginning of Legendary. It is awesome. But I'm not going to play right now. Guys, you know, this is a build guide only to show you the setup of the build. I don't have any upgraded items as you can see. I'm trying these all of my single mastery builds of this series of builds to set up these builds without upgraded items. The idea is to go through the legendary campaign with these setups as they are, as you see them in the build guides, and go throughout the whole campaign legendary, see how well they perform in legendary, and after I finish legendary I will decide which items I want to upgrade, if I will upgrade any items. Maybe I will save my upgrades for other items, for other builds, future builds, because there are many builds coming and also game guides coming in this channel of Titan Quest. Too many actually. So this is it. Don't forget, in tomorrow's live stream, tomorrow is Monday, in tomorrow's live stream I will live stream this build. We will go and see and play with this one in legendary difficulty of course. And we will have lots of gameplay tomorrow in the live stream. Today it is the build guide. So everybody, thanks for watching. Remember to subscribe if you haven't done so. We have lots of content, Titan Quest content mainly coming in the channel. too many videos and live streams of Titan Quest. And I will see you super very soon. Enjoy your day.